Hi there, I'm Dokus, and today we'll get you started with your ATOS Q. In this tutorial, I will show you how to set up the ATOS Q sensor. Feel free to pause at any point to follow along. There are also chapter segments if you wish to skip ahead. Let's get started. In the previous video, I showed you what was inside the case of the ATOS Q sensor and the mobile controller. Now I will show you how to connect the sensor to the laptop with this mobile controller. The main part is this. If we open up the mobile controller, you see in the back that we have some power plugs to connect everything. In the front, we have all our connections to connect the sensor to the laptop. There is one main power cable which I connect to the power net. The next thing is to connect the sensor. The first thing we'll do is put the sensor on the tripod. I can use this sliding mechanism to do that. To secure the sensor, I use the lever. The cable is already connected to the sensor, so we only need to connect the other side to our mobile controller. We have one cable for the power and one cable for the data transfer. To boot the sensor, we just press on. We also need our license key. This tells us which parts of the software we have access to. If you don't have an automatic rotation table, you can already start. Here we have an automatic table, the GOMRA 350, so I will also connect this to our laptop. To connect it to the laptop, I have a USB cable. To supply the table with power, I have a power cord. Now everything is connected. The only thing we need to do now is to open the laptop and boot it. If you experience anything different from what you have seen here, or if you have any issues with your ATOS Q, please reach out to us via support@handsonmetrology.com. For more tutorials, please check out our other videos. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.